The next question is, which term of the AP 3, 8, 13, etc. is 78? So I told earlier, whatever be the question, which all values you have to write A and D. What is A? A equal to 3, first term. Okay. D equal to 8 minus 3, second term minus first term, which gives you 5. Okay. Again, the question is, which term? There are only 3 unknowns in an AP. Which are the unknowns in an AP? A, N and D, isn't it? A is given. D is given. Okay, so the value which is not given is N. Again, read the question, which term? Which term means we have to specify the term in which 78 belongs. Okay, the term, the position of the term 78. That means we have to find the value of N. Okay, so 78. We have to find N for which the term is 78. So what we have to do is we have to take An as 78. Whenever the question is to find the value of n, we have to take An as the given value, 78. What is An? What's the formula? A plus n minus 1 into d is equal to 78. What is A? A is 3 plus n is unknown. So n minus 1 into d is 5 is equal to 78. When an equation comes like this, don't try to take this 5 to the right side first, because this is a single term. What you have to do is take 3 to the right side. So what we will get is n minus 1 into 5 is equal to 78 minus 3, which gives you 75. Okay. Again, take this 5 to the right side. Rather than opening the bracket, take this 5 to the right side. So what we will get, n minus 1 is equal to 75 by 5. 75 by 5 gives you 15. Okay, so n minus 1 equal to 15, and we got the value of n as 16. I told in the beginning, though there are 3 unknowns, A, D and N, A and D can take any real values. The restriction is for N, and N can take only integers. So here we got n as 16, which is an integer. So the answer will be correct.